We want to solve the equation and compound inequality expressed using function notation by using the provided graph. Number one, we have f of x equals g of x, so we want to find the x value for which these two functions are equal. Well, functions are equal when they share the same point or when they intersect. Since this is f of x, and this is g of x, this point of intersection represents when these two functions are equal to each other, where the x-coordinate would be the location and the y-coordinate would be the common function value. Because this is expressed using functions of x, our solution will only be the x-coordinate of this point of intersection, so our solution is x equals 4. Now let's take a look at our compound inequality. We want to solve the compound inequality, g of x less than f of x less than or equal to h of x. Notice how we want to find the x values for which f of x is between g of x and h of x. And it might be helpful to express this as two inequalities connected by the word and. To do this, we would start with f of x and read this from right to left. So we'd have f of x is greater than g of x, and for the second inequality, we start with f of x and read it from left to right. So we also have f of x is less than or equal to h of x. Looking at it this way, for f of x greater than g of x, we want to know when f of x is above g of x, and f of x less than or equal to h of x means we want to know when f of x is also below or equal to h of x. Looking at our graph, notice how f of x is between h of x and g of x along this piece of the line, but we have to express this in terms of x, so we'll project this interval onto the x-axis. But before we do this, let's take a look at the endpoints. We want to know when f of x is greater than g of x, not equal to, so we're not going to include x equals 4. We'd have an open point here. And then for f of x less than or equal to h of x, because f of x can equal h of x, we would include the endpoint of x equals negative 2. So this is a closed point here. And then we also include all the x values between these two. So this interval represents our solution. So to express this using interval notation, we have the interval from negative 2 to positive 4, where it's closed on negative 2 and open on positive 4. We could also express this using inequalities. We could say x is greater than or equal to negative 2 and x is less than 4. Okay, I hope this explanation helps. Thank you for watching.